Mazzy's smiling. Mazzy is happy. It's VCLT for me, from Wa. And a couple of pickups at the record show. Symphonies, great box set. Cartoon music, I love it. Don't you? You totally love it. Okay, I knew some of the stuff was coming. I didn't know what it all was. Some of it I did know. There's three things here, and I'm not doing in any particular order, although I'm gonna just start because I went to the Lake City Record Show over the weekend, and Lake City is about 20 minutes north of downtown Seattle, and they have it once or twice a year, I believe. And I ran into Bo and Hannah again, and they bought me one of my records that I've been trying to get into my collection for XTC. If you've seen my XTC video, there was two records I was missing, and so they gave me this. They said they were sending me something, so there might be something, so maybe I'll do a separate video if that is the case. I'm not expecting it, but hey, I really appreciate it. Thanks, Bo. This is XTC's record, Go 2, their second album. If you don't know the story about this, Hypnosis did all those covers for Pink Floyd and Paul McCartney Wings and a million other artists. They went to a big meeting and had all these presentations for XTC's second, and they hated it. When they were walking out of the office, they saw this. It's sort of their generic, if you read the type, it's a generic album cover for any band. And every band apparently hated it, but it was kind of like buying stock cover concepts. I thought it was pretty cool. So thank you, Bo and Hannah. Great seeing you again. Looks like I'm gonna see them at most of the Northwest events over the next however long. At some point, you're invited for a whack-a-mole here sometime. Who knows, maybe after the holidays. We'll see how that goes. Okay, I'm not going in any particular order, although I scored these boxes because I hate when people spend 13 minutes unscoring a box. I got this from William. William doesn't do videos, but he reached out to me because initially he told me that in my Fillmore Live, Fillmore, one I forgot, which I didn't forget, but I didn't have it, which I wish I did, is Taj Mahal Live at the Fillmore, and he said he had a copy that he was gonna send me. But then he proceeded to come up with a bunch of, like a care package. Should I read it? I'll read it and we'll see if it, I think I can read it. There's nothing, we'll see. Hey Mazzy, here's what I pulled. Hope you enjoy. Took them all off of Discogs and related. But if you're ever looking for something, I'm under, okay, I had his name on Discogs. WB, I won't mention it right now. Maybe you might, if you can have access, some Can would be cool. Oh, Can. I do have three Can albums, but I'm not as knowledgeable. In fact, someone suggested, in terms of suggestions, someone suggested I do a Creedence Clearwater video. You know, I love Creedence Clearwater. To me, there's nothing I can say about CCR that hasn't been said. People know their records. They're all great. Well, they're not all great. The last two are kind of wonky. But I have them all. I love Creedence. I don't have nothing to say to them, except I did see them when I was 14 years old at the San Francisco International Pop Festival in Alameda, California, 1968. And I fell in love because the local station was playing their long version of Suzy Q. So I wouldn't have anything else to say. But Can, I don't know enough about Can. I have two or three other records, and that's about it. So, but anyway, would be cool. Anyway, enjoy. Maybe I might get on a new improved whack-a-mole edition. Ha ha. Well, you're on this edition. This isn't a whack-a-mole edition because these aren't whacked. Well, they're going to be whacked maybe someday. But for right now, Mysterium Delirium was my choice. That was names. That Mysterium, that's a good name actually. Mysterium Delirium. When I was going through my insecurity, whack-a-mole new name, that was one of his titles. I had some great titles. Just, it's a long story. I don't want to waste your time here. So let's see what we have here. You know, taped up box. God, I feel like it's the first night of Hanukkah. You know, this year Hanukkah overlaps Christmas, so us Jewish people, we get a head start on everyone else for Hanukkah. And then when you're finishing up and celebrating Boxing Day and throwing all the recycles away, we're still doing our thing. Not that it's like us against them or you against us, but this is a... He mentioned he had a bunch of records, and I kind of know what these are because he had mentioned these. I think a couple of them I had, but... See, this does take time. It takes too much time to do this. That's why I prefer to... People want to see box opening. You know, I'm sorry. I fucking hate unboxing videos. Okay. Oh. Jazzy. Road Time. Tokido, Arashora, and Lutabakan Big Band on RCA. This is cool. I've never heard this. I know Lutabakan. I've heard of... Toshiko, but I don't have any Toshiko, so this is gonna be great. RCA black label, thank you. Are these part of the other thing? What is this? Ah, this is the top, oh, the real, oh, actually. Oh, the real thing, Taj Mahal. Just the records are out of the cover. This is the live Fillmore record. I don't have this. I've heard it years ago, so I'm really glad to add this to my collection. I'm not going to redo my live Fillmore video, but now we have an addition, so that's always kind of cool. Thank you. Lonnie Mack. I have no Lonnie Mack. This is a later one. I remember seeing this. We sold this. This is 70. I'm going to guess 77, 78. Let's see if I was right. 85. I'm totally wrong. Okay. Alligator Records, blues label, Lonnie Mack, nice hat, nice beard, nice guitar, nice quadruple exposure, Lonnie Mack. I got that date wrong. Yazoo, I love Yazoo Records, and this is great, blues stuff. Country Blues Bottleneck Guitar Classics, 1926 to 1937. Big fan here, Elmore James, Ry Cooter, you know my bottleneck stuff, I mean, Duane Allman. Anybody who plays bottleneck guitar, a little bit of, obviously, George Harrison, Beatle connection. And who else? Well, J.J. Cale, who I just showcased. You have to watch that J.J. Cale video I've done. I just uploaded another one of Gene Clark, so I'm doing these features. But thank you for this. That looks great. 1959, Monterey Jazz Festival, Jimmy Witherspoon, Coleman Hawkins, Roy Etheridge, Ben Webster, Woody Herman. Yep, and then loose albums. Oh, he told me about this. This is like almost like a box, or it's six sides, three records. Energy Essentials, Impulse, Energy Essentials, ABC Impulse. This came out in 72. I worked for them from 77 to 79. I don't think this was out of print by the time I worked for ABC. But it's like a comp, Mingus, Max Roach, Archie Shepp, Freddie Hubbard, Oliver Nelson, John Coltrane, Sonny Rollins, Pharoah Sanders, and so on, Albert Eiler, and Alice Coltrane. Great. Dallas Alice. Not really, but thank you so much. Really cool set. Greatly appreciated it. I did get, this is bizarre, and I don't know, I got it. I don't know if this was intentionally, I opened it up to see, but there was nothing in here, but then I saw a label on here and it scared the shit out of me, because there is no note, it's anonymous, and I don't know if this was meant to be anonymous. I don't even know if this is a VCLT, but when I read this, what this says here, and I'm not gonna read it to you because that'll spoil the surprise, because I can imagine what's in here. This is not a record, I don't think. No, it's not a record because I see what it says here. There's no note, so I don't know if it's in here. So this, either this is an anonymous thing or someone ordered through Amazon without a gift card. Wouldn't that be horrible if that one unscratched the record back there? Jesus Christ. This is like package for kids. Alright, I'm gonna turn this up while you're waiting. I'm sorry.
Brave little moth.
I'm gonna skip ahead. I opened it. Happy. If you're happy with this product and don't know how to express your newfound joy, we've got a few suggestions. Tell your family and friends. Share your experience by writing a review to Amazon. Connect with us on toyssports.com. The whack-a-mole game. And now we gotta open it again. Really? So somebody sent me this, I don't know if they meant, if you want to claim you sent this to me, I don't think this is from John. John, Digital Gramophone, sent me two packages here that I'm going to save to last, just because. Hold one moment, I'll be back. Maxwell Edison, majoring in medicine. Bang, bang, Maxwell Silver Hammer. Are batteries not included? God, what a fucking ripoff. And I gotta click, no, this is not for kids, because I said that. Oh. Well, there's no batteries, so we'll have to, anyway, whack-a-mole. Someone sent me a whack-a-mole game. Who sent this to me? We'll phone you next time. Well, thank you, whoever sent that. Okay, so now we got two packages from John. John, my biggest fan. If you know Digital Gramophone, I'll link these people below. Records are your best entertainment value. Oh, of course, of course. Jason Isbell. He did like a Jason, excuse me, not Jason. Well, Jason Isbell. I don't have any Jason Isbell. I own no drive-by truckers. So this is new to me. I did watch all 47 episode connected videos that John made on the Jason Isbell story and only got through his third grade. So he's probably got another 46 to go before he gets to his first album with the Drive-By Truckers, and then his another 16 episodes for his drug abuse situation, and then another 47 episodes for tuning his Telecaster or Stratocaster guitar. Seriously, I really appreciate it, because I've been toyed with getting some of his records. I've had friends. I almost saw Drive-By Truckers at the Fillmore back in the day when he was in the band, because they kept coming around, and my buddy Vernon, my late friend Vernon, was into Drive-By Truckers and kept asking me to go. For some reason, it just never worked out timing-wise. So, very cool. This is called Southeastern. Now I gotta watch part 16 of his video to figure out what this record's about. So, thank you there. My recycling bin's gonna be full this week. And then we got, wow, two things. God, you're spoiling me here. Hiss, Golden Messenger, Terms of Surrender, Hiss, Golden Messenger, Terms of Surrender on Merge Records. Did you showcase this? I forgot. This looks really familiar, like you, but I don't remember what you said about this. I do pay attention usually, but obviously you know my taste. Taylor has produced quietly at first, and then more loudly, one of the most impressive bodies of songwriting of the past 10 years. So, we got this album. I'm looking forward to this. This is really cool. Love that cover. Looks like a bird's nest, a pubic hair bird's nest. Wow, okay. On the second night of Hanukkah, I should have lit the candles for your night. And there's one more box. Also, he told me one box arrived end of last week, and John told me to wait to open it at the same time. So, this item has been repackaged and, okay. His Golden Messenger cassette. So it looks like, is this a, did he make this? It's in pink. It's in Eric pink cassette color. Can you see that? The lighting here gets wonky or it gets bright. And it looks like he basically taped one of his albums and sent me a cassette. So I want to thank John for violating the copyright of this artist. And remember what they used to say back in the 70s? Home taping is killing the record industry. You need Hiss, good buddy. Oh, you need this? You need Kiss, good buddy. 9:30 Club, 4/23/2017. So it sounds like it's a live gig. Okay, we'll check that out. And then, fuck, it is like Christmas here. A cozy or a. Hold on a second. I'm turning totally red. I'm turning. Look at that. That's psychedelic. This is as creepy as it is cool, and it's funny as it is cool. It's those little things. Mazzy loves you. And I can take on this on the road, so I can take a pitcher full of martinis when I'm driving down I-5 to Portland, Oregon. I don't drink in the car, I kid. Coffee, cold drinks, I'm not a soft drink person. But I have a Dr. Pepper now and then. That's kind of a Southern thing, isn't it? For you Southern boys? Love, if I'm gonna have I can't drink Coca-Cola. Fanta, I used to drink. But anyway, root beer, Dr. Pepper were the ones, so. But coffee, can I put hot drinks in this? Is that gonna wreck my hat and my goatee? Boy, talk about an identity crisis here. I love this. Mazzy loves you. Thanks, CC. Thanks, John. John rocks. And there's something else here. So this is, there's a couple. Wow, what is this? Mazzy condoms. No, I'm kidding. This is Lunchbox Records, best vinyl selection in town. Is it a key ring or it's like a, what the fuck is this? Is it a magnet, a key ring? What is this? It must be a magnet, right? Is that a magnet? I have no idea what this is. It must be a magnet, or it's like a Lunchbox Records. I mean, I need to come and meet Chris and everybody at Lunchbox and go to Noble Records and see Dave and maybe Bill, Vinyl Verse can make me pick out the best Phil Collins record for me. And then lastly, did you go through all your like your parents' your old bedroom and take all the shit out of your bedroom and send it to me? I'm kidding. Is this because I'm so retro? You kind of got a retro because I'm so old. I'm like, you got a retro. Everything fucking needs batteries or USB plugs. what the fuck is this? So it's like a, is it a radio or a? His master's voice. John, you rock. Thank you. You all rock. Everybody rocks. I really appreciate it. Thanks for watching. this is hysterical. I want this to last forever. Right? What do you do here? So fast forward, you put USB. I guess I can play. Oh, I bet you I could play my iPhone music through here, right? So that's what it is. So you kind of got the new and the old. So my Medicare card, do I get a discount playing with this? I don't know. Anyway, thank you everyone. And until the next whack-a-mole, I'll have batteries next time for this, maybe. And I really appreciate it. It was nice seeing Han and Bo briefly over the weekend. And thanks for the big Boss William and everybody. So Mazzy loves you. And have a nice week.
Wait, stop. Don't go anywhere. Don't go anywhere. There's more. Couple things. First of all, how can I be so stupid? Of course I know what this is. It's a 45 adapter. Magnet. Jesus Christ, Mazzy, pay attention. 45 adapter from Lunchbox Records. Nice heavy one. So I'll be able to use it on my turntable there. But also, I feel like a kid, you know, when you open Christmas presents or birthday presents, you don't look. There was a fucking card hidden in there, and it says spoilers. Turn this down a little bit. This is handheld cinema verite, the ending bit. Can I read it, or is this private stuff? Is this all like, okay. Hey, Mazzesti. Ooh, Mazzesti. This is from John, digital gramophone. I've been working on a VCLD package to send you for a little while. Am I gonna embarrass you? I'll stop if it gets kind of like really intimate here. I had to break up the content into two packages. One box's contents speak for themselves. This one with the records is fairly easy to explain as well. Both albums are by two artists I've done spotlights on. Of course you have, and I kind of missed that one. So there we go. Jason Isabel's Southeastern is devastatingly good. I'm glad it's devastating. I'm gonna be devastated. I can't wait to put it on my turntable and get devastated. Let me move out of the way. I need a little more space here to get more light on this card. I struggle deciding which his golden messenger plea to send you. I'm glad you struggled. People, Americans should struggle and know what it's really about to struggle. To send you until I saw them live recently. MC Taylor introduced the song Down in the Uptown with the background story. Before moving to North Carolina, he was a band based in San Francisco. They frequently played a dive club in a hip yet rundown part of town. The club was called the Uptown. Why not the Uptown? The Uptown was in Oakland, I think. Wasn't the Uptown in Oakland? I've been to the Uptown. There's an Uptown in Oakland. I think you're talking about the Uptown in Oakland. I could be wrong, but I think so. So San Francisco reference was the deciding factor. I think you will enjoy the music. I've thoroughly enjoyed our interaction in the VC. Your videos are a joy to watch. More fully, hopefully we can hang out sometime. Cheers, John. Mazzy loves you.